So in the last few weeks, we've all seen the amazing stats come in for crime in Wilmington. In 1 year, we've had these unprecedented improvements. Gun homicides are down 41%. Shootings in general are down 56%, more than half. And a lot has been attributed to these improvements. But we're very happy today to be joined by Mayor Mike Purzycki and Chief Bob Tracy to talk about what has actually made this happen. Like, how did this happen? And we want to talk about the four major factors that they've been talking about that has led to this incredible improvement. And those four factors are something called CompStat, intelligence-led policing, directed patrols, and community engagement. So let's just start with the hard one. What is CompStat, and how is that helping so much in Wilmington?
Sure. CompStat's a basic methodology that started out in 1994 with a man named Bill Bratton, who came to New York and brought these type of strategies to the NYPD. I had been with the NYPD from 1984 to 1994, and we were reactive policing. And at that time, we had 2,245 shootings in a city of 7.5 million people. And he brought these strategies in, and it's really about computer statistics. And you do a comparative analysis on a 7-day, 28-day, and a year-to-date basis. And the 7-day compares 7 days versus the same period last year. You have emerging trends and patterns for murder, rape, robbery, aggravated assault, burglary, felony theft, and motor vehicle theft. And then you do a comparative analysis, and you break it out into areas to see what's emerging, what trends, what's rising in each area. And then on a 28-day, you do the same period against the same time last year, and you see exactly what's going on. And then that's where you start to see patterns. And if things are going up, it makes our commanders, it makes the command staff understand what's going on with these statistics and what we need to start looking at and addressing. And obviously, you have year-to-date comparative analysis. And that shows you how you're trending throughout the year and are you getting better. But within that 7-day, 28-day period, there's a lot of work that's being done, a lot of analysis is being done, and then it's pushed down to the streets in an operational-based strategy.
So it's sort of like if you know that this week, every year, there's this much activity and it's happening generally in these areas, you can plan ahead to have police already there? Is that the idea?
You can forecast. Yeah, it's one way to do it. But you actually start to see the trends. You don't really have to have all this predictive analytics and everything, especially when it comes to crime. Using this type of system, reporting against the same time, and you really want to compare against the same period last year or the years before, because crime sometimes is seasonal, and you get a real good comparative analysis. And then, like I said, you can look at it emerging in a 7-day, if it's increasing compared to what we had last year. And then, in a 28-day period, you really start to look at a 4-week period, and that's where you really see the patterns. You look at time of day, day of week, and things and people, and then you start to put a strategy together to deploy in the right area, look at the people who might be committing the crimes, and then those plans, you go out and execute them, and it brings the crime down overall.
Nice. I like it.
You gave that speech in the interview. That's why I hired
That's why you hired him.
It's the same. It's the exact same
exact
speech.
How is it different from the way that you guys were doing it before, though? Like, how is it different?
Well, I don't think, frankly, I'm not knowledgeable enough to get into that. I would say that the chief just has brought a systematic approach to policing that I think permeates the entire department. And it's pretty obvious to everybody who's around our police officers today that culture has changed dramatically, and it's one that I personally subscribe to and I'm very supportive of.
Yeah. I'm seeing a change in policing from Newcastle County to the city of Wilmington, where you're using CompStat and statistics, where Newcastle County is using like mental health, how they're associating crime to mental health. And I applaud both of you, both departments, because there is a change. I remember in Wilmington, there was a shooting every day, and people were actually scared to go outside or travel or to come in town to shop and all that. So, Mayor, I want to ask you, how does CompStat help you understand the city more?
Well, in every department, I always think more data and more information is better. So it's not just police, but it's throughout the entire city. I try to somehow convert what we see in our daily lives into statistics so I can measure performance. Oddly enough, we have taken CompStat that was basically employed down in Baltimore with Martin O'Malley, who came up to visit us, and he converted that into CityStat. And so we are doing precisely what the chief does. We are beginning to do CityStat in our City Hall with every single department. So we will, as the chief meets with everybody, and you've got to go there. I don't suppose he would let you go there, but there are portions of it that if you saw it, you'd be so impressed with how hard they drill down on what's going on in this neighborhood,
right.
Who's involved, what do you know about the people, the perpetrators, what do you know about related individuals, what have you done about one bit of follow-up after another. And so we're taking that same thing into L&I, believe it or not, in planning and public work. And said, you have goals. You set goals 2 weeks ago. What have you done?
Right.
Whereas, frankly, today we haven't been doing that.
Right.
Well, we're going to go on. Is what you're talking about a little bit the intelligence-led policing piece? Well,
yeah. And one of the things, it's really CompStat is also business management principles that apply to police work. Yeah. And it's really not when people talk about the numbers. It's not about the outputs. It's about the outcomes.
Right.
And so, are they getting the outcomes that we're desiring to reduce crime and make sure it's not about arresting everyone. It's making sure we're reducing crime. And one of the things, and the four tenets of CompStat are timely and accurate intelligence that's disseminated to all. Then it's rapid deployment that's focused and synchronized. It's effective tactics and strategies. And the fourth one that is really, really important is relentless follow-up and assessment. So you follow up to see if it's working, continue to do it. If it's not working, then let's find out where it broke down, try to fix it, and if we have the fidelity plan that's been put into place and it's not working at all, let's scrap it and say, let's do something different. It's very flexible, and it breaks it down by neighborhood. So we got to remember, it's not overall. We look at it from citywide, but then we break it out. We have three sectors, and each sector has three districts within it, and I have a captain commander over each one of those areas, and that leads into the intelligence-led policing. It leads into the directed patrols, and it leads to the community engagement I know we're going to get into next. So CompStat is a lot more than what I just told you, but it also encompasses what we're going to talk about in the next segments.
It actually reminds me a lot of, and we got to wrap up this segment, but it reminds me a lot of...
I had a bunch of questions, Chief.
No, I know, but we're going to go right on to intelligence-led policing, okay. But I'm reading the four disciplines of execution, you know, for my business, which it has some overlap with that, you know, like that just tracking lead measures, knowing, you know, what to do. So thank you for that information. We're going to go on to the next segment and talk about intelligence-led policing.
But we got to finish this segment with this. Congratulations on the award that you received for CompStat. Didn't you get an award for that?
Well, it was actually the acting attorney general. We got one of two departments in the United States that received a Project Safe Neighborhoods Crime Reduction Award. So it's a pretty prestigious award, but I didn't receive it. The city of Wilmington and the offices that did the work received it.
Awesome.
And the work that they did, and also a partnership with a federal and state partner, so as well as the U.S. Attorney's Office and the Attorney General's Office, Department of Corrections, Probation and Parole. This is a concerted effort, and it goes into the community engagement, because that award was a recognition for everyone in the city and actually the mayor's leadership and how we've pulled this all together.
Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And if you have any positive stories that Zach and myself need to talk about, be sure to submit it at stories.wilmington.love.